1077 The Bone, the Bay Area's rock station. Leonard Skinner, Sweet Home, Alabama. 845 and a good-looking day today. Paul, very excited. We have a very special guest in the studio.
Yeah, how about that? Kevin Nealon from Saturday Night Live fame and currently on Weeds on Showtime.
Yeah.
How are you doing, Kevin?
I'm doing great. Have you seen Weeds yet?
No.
I have seen Weeds. It is a great show.
Oh, I'm glad you like it. Well, that's... Yeah. A lot. So here's what I hear a lot. You know, when I was on Saturday Night Live, I had a lot of people say, "Yeah, we don't stay up that late." And now I'm on a series on Showtime. Yeah, we don't get Showtime.
Hold it. Who doesn't get Showtime nowadays?
Well, a lot of people don't get Showtime.
Really?
Yeah, yeah.
That's what they're telling you.
Yeah, that's what they're telling me. But it's a great series, and I'm having fun doing it. We start a third season on Monday. We start taping, and it'll probably start airing beginning of August. So it's good, and it's, the demographics are good. I'll be in a mall, and this kid will come up to me and say, "Hey, dude, we love your show, man. Weeds, it's kicks, man. It's kicks." Then I'll go around the corner, and be like 4 7-year-old ladies, and they go, "Honey, we love your show."
Nice.
You know, and it's pretty controversial. And
I was going to say, now with the show Weeds, are you meeting people who smoke a lot of dope?
Yes, yes. And they assume that I want to go out and smoke dope with them after a show, you know. But it's not like that. You know, it's not like... It's like it's Sex in the City. I wonder if they had people come up to him afterwards. "Hey, man, you want to fool around?"
And while I've missed Weeds, I do remember you as, if I remember right, 1987 in Roxanne, you were drunk guy number two.
Drunk number two.
Come on. Right.
Yeah. Me and Rich Scheidner. Rich Scheidner was drunk number one. I auditioned for drunk number one, but I can only get drunk number two. Yeah. Yeah. Yep. That was it. That was it. That was fun. And Steve Martin, I've always been a fan of his. And when he hosted Saturday Night Live, that was it for me, you know.
Yeah.
And James Taylor. I was a fan of James Taylor. So those guys both were on together, and I was like in heaven. You know what I mean?
Did you go and do anything for James Taylor, like drunk number two at his show?
No. Actually, I did do something for him. I actually hosted a show that he had on A&E Network, I think it was.
Really?
It was called Live by Request. Mm-hmm. People would call in, and we were on, and I was the host, and it was fantastic. It was like my dream come true.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah, it was great. It was great.
So now, Saturday Night Live, you brought up Saturday Night Live. Do you ever see any of the guys that you used to do Saturday Night Live with and perform with?
Oh, yeah. I see a lot of them. I see Dana Carvey all the time. I talk to him a lot. Sandler, Adam Sandler. You know, Sandler's been good. You know, Sandler's been doing a lot of putting me in some of his movies, you know. But it's getting to the... It's getting embarrassing because they're usually humiliating parts. You know what I mean? I was in Happy Gilmore. That was cool.
Right. Great movie.
A psychic, kind of a spiritual advisor on the golf green. But then Little Nicky came along, and he wanted me to play the gatekeeper of hell, and I had breasts on my head. Harvey Keitel cast a spell on me, and I had to grow these breasts, and it was a little humiliating, you know. And then the next movie was Anger Management. I had to play his gay lawyer, you know. and then there was a pilot that he did where it never aired, but it was with two comedians, and he calls me, he goes, "Hey, Nealon, I wonder if you play you play yourself in this pilot, but you know you don't have genitalia, you just have a mound like a Ken doll. You know? You want to do that?" I said, "Sure, whatever. But you're playing yourself, though. Okay, all right. And luckily that never aired. But now whenever he calls for a movie, I kind of like avoid the phone call.
So he's kind of dicking with you. So I'll get Nealon to do this.
Yeah. How can I embarrass Nealon? Let me see. That's the only reason he does movies, I think, to embarrass me. Is it Sandler? I'm not here.
Hey, another thing I saw. What is the deal with all the wiretapping? You were wiretapped?
I was wiretapped not only once, but apparently by several different companies.
Really?
Well, one of them was the Pelicano case, which was pretty high profile. That's
the private investigator?
Yeah, the private investigator from Los Angeles. And it was the weirdest thing because I opened up the New York Times, and here's my picture between... You know, Stallone and some other high-profile person, you know? And I'm thinking, wow, that's kind of strange.
Now, why was he tapping your phone?
Good question. I think there was probably a lawsuit going on between a friend of mine and some lawyer and, you know, because I would call this friend.
Yeah.
You know, they thought maybe they could tap me in for something. I don't know. I have no idea.
But now the weird thing is Ringling Brothers Barnum and Bailey Circus was tapping your phone?
Allegedly they were, yeah.
that
was
that
like in
about?
The 80s or 90s. Well, at the time I was doing some animal activism work, and we were outside protesting Ringling Brothers For their abuse of animals, you know, because, you know, they take these animals. Everybody grows up loving the circus, you know, mm-hmm. but you don't really know what's going on with the animals behind the scenes. You know, these elephants that are so, you know, they're sentient creatures, and, you know, they should be free, but they're chained up and they're broken down and they're hauled on trains all over the country, you know, and they're on chains pretty much all day except for an hour or two when they're performing. So it's kind of inhumane. So anyway, you know, we were protesting that outside, and I did that, I think, one time. And then, like a year later, I heard that my phone was tapped. And I got to tell you, sometimes I'd be on my phone at that time, and I would hear like little taps. And I, kiddingly, I'd say, "Ooh, sounds like our phone's being tapped. Let's be careful."
8:51. Kevin Nealon is here. Don't budge from your radio. I wanna run to your wicked garden. That's a place to find you. Just like a child. Can you see just what I